If you'd like to work along with me with the same documents I'm using, I will place them out on the website, thefrugalcomputerguy.com. Go to the video tutorials and Office Writer here. You can click that, or down at the bottom here, clicking on that will take you to the LibreOffice Writer video tutorial page. I will place them out here shortly. There are some more options that I wanted to go over about printing. If we go into File, Print, actually before we go there, let's look at this preview in web browser. And if we save our LibreOffice Writer file as an HTML formatted file, it would look like this if we open it up in a web browser. And this is the preview of it, which it looks okay. We probably want to center that our logo a little better. But if you want a static website, you can use LibreOffice Writer to create a quick and simple web page. Back to the printing. And looking at the dot, 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 print, dot, 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 export, save as, open. That basically, the dot, dot, dots mean that there's going to be a dialog box or more options. That's what we want to see right now, our print options. Here we've got a print preview and the pages. One, we can click this arrow, two, three, or we can just jump to the page we want by typing it in. And I'm taking us back to page one. We can print all pages, or using the radio button, we can select a certain number of pages, maybe only page two. Also, if we were on all pages and I just click on this box, this will work as well. So if we want to print pages one and four, we'd put 1, 4, and you see that there's two pages, 1 and 4. If we want to print 1 through 4, or maybe we'll do like 2 through 4, we need the dash, and I need to take out that comma. So 2 through 4. So now we have three pages that are queued up for printing, 2, 3, and 4. And if I go to the print layout tab, you see that we still only have pages two of three, because that's what we told it. So let's go back to the general, because we only have 2 through 4. So we have 2, 3, and 4. So we got our three pages, 3, 2, and 1. But I want to have all, I'm just clicking back to all pages. So when we go back to our layout, we see that we have 1 of 4. Now looking at pages per sheet, it has a 1 here, and you might not know what that is until we change it to 2. When we see 2 pages per sheet, we see that 1 is here and 2 is on the right. 1 is on the left, 2 is on the right. It'll come out landscaped. We'll go over landscape and portrait in a separate video. For now, we can see 2 pages. Let's put all 4 pages onto 1 printed page. And here we see 1, 2, 3, 4. Here's our first page, second page, third page, fourth page. So it's telling you left to right, then down, and we can change that top to bottom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's go back to one page per sheet. And we can print all pages. We can print just the back sides or front sides, which is also the left or right when we looked at that book printing. So if I have a single page printer, can only print one, or single sided printer, I may want to print all the front sides, print that out, put those sheets back in the printer, and then print all the back sides so I can get double-sided on my one-sided printer. Let's print all pages again. One other option, or in the options, I wanted to point out, for some of you that have those old, old printers that print one sheet out and then print the second sheet face up and it lands right on top, you may want to use this print in reverse order. Most printers these days print them out normally, so it's not an issue. But if some of those are still out there, that's what this print in reverse order might help you out with. So there we have our print dialog box.